Diffusion can be a great alternative to absorption for those who are looking to keep some of the liveliness in their room. Diffusion can also make some rooms sound larger and even out harsh reflections, but understanding how diffusion works and, more importantly, how to properly implement it is going to be necessary if you want these desired effects. See, a hard flat surface like drywall will always reflect sound back off at the opposite angle that it struck the wall at. This is why we always treat our first reflections with thick absorption. Those sound packets are always going to arrive at the listener's ear slightly after that original sound, causing all sorts of issues in the stereo image. Diffusion works by breaking up these reflections and scattering them around the room evenly in all directions. This means they reach the listening position at different times and intensities. This scattering can happen spatially, with diffusion pointing sound off in all different directions, but some diffusion can actually work temporally, with certain sound waves being delayed and others not. Good diffusion can trick your ears into not recognizing the natural dimensions of a room through its echo. A professional piece of diffusion should evenly scatter sound in a 180-degree cone. GIK products like the Goth and the Alpha series are mathematically formulated to give that perfectly even scattering. Good diffusion does not happen by accident. These panels are specifically engineered to give an even and effective scattering. Some people might suggest using a bookcase filled with books as a cheap alternative to diffusion, but a random assortment of books isn't going to give you the effect that a professional piece of treatment will. It might perform better than a piece of drywall, but it's not going to give you the even scattering that you need for the desired effect. Diffusion also mostly only works in your mid-range. Your high treble and your low bass aren't going to be effective as much. A piece of diffusion that's large enough to affect bass tones would be so large it wouldn't even fit on the truck, so it's not really feasible for most studios. This is why we recommend that you do your bass trapping in your first reflection, and then add diffusion to help balance out your room sound. Diffusion in a small room can be tricky, as some pieces of diffusion require space between them and the listening position in order to work properly. If that diffusion is too close to the listening position, then the sound won't have the space it needs to scatter out evenly. You might even start to hear individual resonances from the different well depths of your piece of diffusion. Diffusion comes in all sorts of shapes and sizes, and while there are many methods of diffusion, it can all be broken down into two main categories, either one-dimensional or two-dimensional. The number of dimensions refers to the number of planes that the sound is scattered across. So a one-dimensional piece of diffusion will scatter sound either vertically or horizontally, depending on the orientation of the panel. A two-dimensional piece of diffusion will scatter sound both vertically and horizontally. One-dimensional diffusion tends to be a bit more efficient, so you're getting more diffusion concentrated across one dimension. These are great for back walls and listening rooms and studios where your listening position isn't going to move. Two-dimensional diffusion tends to be a little less efficient, but it scatters across two dimensions. So these work really well on ceilings or in live rooms where your microphone and instrument placement might vary from performance to performance. Many GIK products can take a scatter plate in them, which converts a regular bass trapper panel to have scattering and a little bit of diffusion. Our Alpha series panels are a more balanced hybrid absorption diffusion that comes in both a one-dimensional and two-dimensional variant. Our Impression series panels are remarkably similar to the Alphas, only the plates are designed with aesthetics in mind over diffusion performance. In many cases, though, the Impression and Alpha series can be used interchangeably. Many professional studios use diffusion to great effect, but understanding how diffusion works and how to properly implement it in your space is going to be key to getting the maximum benefit. If you still have questions about diffusion, or if you want to know what products are best for your space, drop us a line on our website or be sure to fill out our free acoustic advice form, and one of our room designers will get you a tailored advice specific for your room. Get free acoustic advice. Visit GIKacoustics.com for educational articles and tutorials.